Hello everyone, how are you all? Welcome back to the IT class, right? This is your IT teacher Sumit Sadhana. So in the last videos we have covered half of our chapter, right, of electronic spreadsheet. In this video we'll be dealing about our session 2's video, right? That is link, data and spreadsheet. As you can see on your computer screen, the topic is already opened. So our first topic is using multiple workbooks and linking cells. So till solver tool, we were using those tools in OpenOffice, right? But now onwards we'll be opening another application software, that is MS Excel. So let's get started with this without wasting much time. So first one is your identifying sheets. Let me open for you what is MS Excel. Some of you might know that what is MS Excel. So this whole screen is known as a spreadsheet, right? And under the spreadsheet category, this file name is known as the workbook. That's why the book one is written here. Workbook, under the workbook we have several sheets, but by default we have only three sheets, which is shown here, and rest you can add according to your desire, according to your requirement. Okay, so let's see what is our topic. Identifying sheets, you can see a small screenshot is given to you, and this is basically 2013 version. Okay, 2013 onwards version, the layout of this image. This is 2010, okay, and we have three sheets here, but here they have shown only one sheet, just to give you the demonstration of plus sign. Plus denotes to insert new sheet, okay. So this plus sign basically is insert new sheet. So I'll be telling you with the comparison with other application softwares, right, with the different versions. So this is sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, and this icon will is basically giving you the caption, that is insert worksheet, and a shortcut key is also provided to you, that is shift F11. If I'll be pressing shift F11, so here you go, sheet 4 is inserted. And this was basically a shortcut or a practical way without wasting time. So another way is what you have to do theoretically, the steps you are to create for your theoretical exams and all. So how you will write, you'll click on home tab, because these are the tabs we are saying it as, right? Tabs, we are not saying it as menus, right? We are calling them tabs, and under the tabs this is the whole ribbon area where you have multiple groups. Group means this is clipboard group, this is font group, alignment group, number group, styles, cells, and editing group. So in under the cells group we have insert icon. So here basically under the groups we have tools in the form of icons, and text is also written, but in OpenOffice we are having only icons, the tools in the form of icons, no text or caption is written there. So we were, you know, unable to identify which tool is which. We have to hover the mouse over the icon again and again to see which is the insert icon, which is the, you know, wrap text or merge icon or tool. So we'll click on insert, fourth option, that is insert sheet. Insert sheet, click here, and sheet 5 is inserted. You can already see that. Okay, so this was how to identify the sheets and all. This is the base steps to insert a sheet. Okay, the screenshot is also given here. So how to rename a worksheet? So if I want to rename this sheet 1 to practice, so I'll be right clicking here, and a context menu appeared. In that, rename option is there. So I'll be writing practice, okay, then enter. After that, another way which is not given there, just double click sheet 2, practice 2, okay, and enter, done. So this is double click is also given, right click is also given, or select the worksheet you want to rename, click on the worksheet tab, then select the sheet option from the format menu, right? Basically that is a lower, you know, format menu they have told to us. So this means they might be you know, dealing with the different version here, right? And let's see if it's here or not. That is home, right? Data review. Can you see that? No option is given here, that format and all, right? So format as table, these are the cell referencing. Here you can see format. Okay, so basically the motive of explaining these all tabs to you is because we don't have a format menu here in 2010 version, because they have asked for format menu, but in 2013 onwards they are having format menu there, right? But we'll call it in the MS Excel format as under the home tab, under inside the cells group, we have a format tool, okay, or the icon or the option, sub option. If we'll be clicking on the format sub option arrow, small icon, will be having a rename sheet. So if I'll be clicking on rename sheet, the access goes directly here, and if you want to change practice one, you just write it and just rename it. Okay, so this was renaming worksheets and all. Now is create or change the cell reference. So you must know what is cell reference, what is cell address, range of cells and all. So I'll be telling you, I have clicked here, let me zoom, I have clicked here, so this, and I have inputted 56 here. So basically, what is the cell address of this? The value of this cell is 56, but the cell address is C2. You can see here also. Okay, C2 is the cell address. And if I'll be selecting more than one cell, this is known as range of cell, and this is the range of, you know, C2, and you have to see diagonally C2 to F6. Okay, so this is the range C2 to F6. Okay, this one, C2 to F6 is the range, and after that, this is the range of cell. This is the cell, okay, and what is an active cell? Active cell is, you know, you have to see here, and this is an active cell, okay. How you identify this is an active cell? The thick black bordered, right, wherever this thick black bordered is there in the cell, that is known as active cell, because we have selected this. Okay, next comes your cell reference to other sheets, but see what is the cell reference. Suppose C2 is equal to 56, okay, and I want F2 also 56. So what I'll be doing, I'll be taking a reference from C2. So every formula starts with equal sign, equal to, and I'll be writing here the cell address of this C2, because C2 is holding 56. So I'll be writing C2 and will press enter. 56 is referred here via C2 cell. Okay, clear. And next is referencing to the cell reference with the other sheets. So you must see, I'll be clicking sheet 5 here. So just remember, this is C2 where 56 is there, and I want the cell reference 52 here in D7. Okay, so I'll be writing equals to, then I'll be writing the sheet name practice 1, then exclamatory sign, then I'll be writing C2, enter. Okay, it is asking for basically the, why it is asking, okay, one is there, all right, just see, let me equals to practice 1 C2, okay, enter. Here you go, we got this 56, because it was here in C2. I have taken a reference of C2 and I have done here, I have done the referencing between the two sheets. Okay, and see the next one. The next one is, see here, I have written 95 here. So B3 is holding the value 95, and I want 95 on practice 1. So on A1 I want 95 value. So what I'll be writing equals to, then I'll be writing the name of the sheet, practice, then exclamatory sign, then I'll be writing C2 and press enter. Okay, let me see where I have written. Okay, I have written in B3, so here I'll be writing B3 basically, B3 and enter. Okay, so 95 is referenced from another sheet. So how we are referencing here, just see here, because they have already given the example and I have shown you practically. Suppose this is practice sheet, 95 is written here. How to refer from the other sheet? So what you have to do is, you have to write equal to sign, then name of the sheet is practice, then exclamatory sign, which is separating these two things, okay, the sheet name and the range or the cells, okay, exclamatory sign, then the cell address in which the value is present. So I want 95, which was present in B2 in practice sheet. So after entering, I got 95 directly here. Okay, easy. Yeah, it was very simple. So let's do some operations, arithmetic operations. So this is 45, 65, 75. So we'll be, you know, finding the average. Let me find the average of these two. So you must know the formula of finding the average. Sum of all the observation divided by number of observations, correct? So equals to, because average is a built-in function, a formula, so I have to write average, right? Return average, bracket start, then I'll be selecting the range with the, either with the mouse or you can write it directly, the range. I told you how to write a range, is starting with B3 to B6, okay? B6. So I'm pressing enter, I got 70. 70 is an average. Okay, so let's do it manually here. Equals to bracket start, then I'll take a reference, then 45, then 65, then 75. I've given the references, put in a bracket because this is a single entity, divide by 4. So you got it. 70 is the, you know, average value, and next is your next topic, that is to the other sheet we'll be finding the average, okay, of these 4 cells only. Okay, so we'll be finding the average on practice 1 equals to, wait a minute, before we write, you have to note down the range. It is B3 to B6. Okay, just keep in mind B3 to B6. So I'll be writing equals to, then average, then bracket start, then you were writing the range here, but before range you have to write down the sheet, because the range is on the other sheet. So you have to write practice, then exclamatory sign, B3 to B6. Okay, then enter. You got it? 70, 70, 70. You got the same answer. So this is known as cell referencing on one sheet, cell referencing between the sheets. Okay, so this we have already done, referencing with the sheets and all. So next with hyperlinks, very much important. So how to create hyperlink? Hyperlink basically is the one which helps you to navigate from one file to another file, one web page to another page, like your Facebook social networking site is there, your Snapchat is there. When you click on any of the menu or any of the link, suppose you want to go to your timeline of Facebook, you will click the timeline, right? Click on the timeline, your profile will open there. When you want to go to the news feed, you click on the news feed, then automatically the present page will convert it into your news feed page, okay, because they are navigating between pages. So likewise, hyperlink also work with the same criteria, with the same procedure at the background. So what I want here, I have written link to other file. Okay, so I have written link to other file. So what I want to click on the link to other file. Then after that, whatever background path I'll be putting inside these words, it will open the file. So right click, hyperlink, right click or hyperlink. So give the address. Suppose these are the files. So you can navigate from here. Either my file is in my computer D drive. So I want to open this HTML and okay. Okay, so now the text turned blue because blue is the hyperlink or the link color. So I'll be clicking on the hyperlink. Can you see that there is a difference of the icon, because the icon is getting changed when I'm hovering the mouse over the text. Now is a plus sign, outlined plus sign. When I hover the mouse over the text, that is converted into hand. Click here, it will ask, do you want to continue opening it? Yes. So this is the HTML Roblox file, right? Some student have made. So your job is done. You want to give the link, you click here, you open it. You can open any of the file from any application. Okay, so this basically concept is very much vast. This is having a vast scope of opening the file. You can open any of the file. Okay, but just you are giving a link, you are linking the Excel to the other file. Next is, or the shortcut is Control K. I have written link here, so I'll be pressing Control K and give the students link. Click OK. Yes. Okay, so this student database is opened. Clear? Or you want to insert the link. So what you have to do, write down, or you can write anything, Google also you can write. So let me show you. I have written Google here. So I'll open the Firefox, just a runtime example, google.com. so it is opened here. So this full path I'll copy, okay, and I'll paste it here. You want to insert the hyperlink, so go to insert tab, then links, hyperlink, you just paste it here. Okay, so you click on the Google and here you go, the Google link is opened in the Firefox, okay, or in any of the browser, whatever is installed in your system. Clear? Means the scope is very much vast, very much wide. You can open any of the file, web page. Okay, so when you press Control K, here it is written, existing file or web page, place in the document. Okay, you can, means you can do the cell referencing, you can do the linking between the sheets, create a new document. You want to create a new document, you want to send a mail, so you can do the same too. Okay, next is your sharing worksheet and creating macros. Okay, that I'll be explaining to you in the next video. Okay, so just read it and I'll be coming in the next video to explain you how to share the worksheet data and how to create a macro. Very much important. Okay, I hope you understood it. And if you have any kind of query, just ask through the official channels, whatever is told you, that is via ERP, or you can write down in the comment box also. Okay, all right. Okay, good day ahead.